Hello there. How you all doing? Hello there, doggy. You all wet, ain't ya?
Well, hello.
Hello. Hello.
Oh boy, that's enough of that for today. Sure.
Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear words they're saying. Only the echoes of my mind. People stop and stare. I can't see their faces. Only the shadows of their eyes. I'm going where the sun keeps shining through the pouring rain. Going well, the weather suits my clothes. Banking off of the northeast winds, sailing on summer breeze. And skipping over the ocean like a stone. My clothes, banking off of the northeast winds, sailing on summer breeze, and skipping over the ocean like a stone. Everybody's talking at me, can't hear a word they're saying. Only the echoes of my mind. I won't let you leave my love behind. No, I won't let you leave.
Nobody about today up this end. Maybe they're in Valentine. I think I might go out to the west today. Hi-ho, Hazel! Away!
Oh. to me.
There's a snake in my boot.
Oh, sorry. I'll get out of your way.
Thank you.
I love your outfit.
Thanks very much. My mother bought it for me when the fair came to Colchester when I was 14.
Wait, you've had the same outfit since you were 14?
No, it was a bit too long for me then, so my mother had to roll up the sleeves and the trousers. Thanks very much. Yeah, she got it off a man who had a hamburger and hot dog stall. And his name was Woody, and his stall was called Woody's Ground Up.
Oh. Wait, there was someone selling clothes that just sold food? What?
Well, my mother had a nice chat with him and went off to clean his caravan for about 10 minutes. And then when she came back, she had these clothes in her hands. And she said, Woody's a bit tied up right now, so we have to leave right away. So we did.
Oh, I think your mum was a whore.
I beg your pardon?
Nothing.
Don't you dare talk about my mother like that.
Oh, I think what he meant to say is your mum was very wholesome.
Yeah, like that, yeah. A working woman.
She's a cleaner. She works upstairs cleaning the rooms.
Well, we were talking about her experience with Mr. Woody there.
Well, she went in to clean his caravan.
Oh, so I'm pretty sure she cleaned something of his, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, his caravan.
Yeah, something of his, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, she did a really good job for him to get the clothes.
Absolutely, yeah.
Sorry, I didn't quite hear you there.
Oh, don't worry about it.
I'm sorry.
I had an insect just buzzing in my ear then for a moment.
Oh, all right, yeah. Careful about them, right? I've heard there's some insects that they crawl in your ears and then they eat your brain.
Oh, what are they called then?
I don't know. I've just heard about them.
Earwigs.
Oh, maybe. That's a good name for them. We should call them that.
Yeah, I think earwigs do that.
Oh, that sounds absolutely terrifying.
Yeah, I wouldn't like it happening to me. I think it was just a fly.
Well, that is fortunate. Anyway, so, shall we check that Mr. Hank hasn't died yet?
Yes.
Yeah, go on then. Nice to meet you, person.
Yeah, my name's Rodney Spencer. Very rude man. Go and see if my mother's about. Hello, Mum. How you doing? Yeah, I'm not too bad. I've been doing more fishing. I caught a legendary fish the other day. Got quite a lot of money for it. Yeah, I'm keeping all right. You know, staying out of trouble. Well, trying to. Just spoke to a very rude man downstairs. Won't have any of that. I've already beaten up one ruffian. Yeah, I know, I'll be careful. Yeah, I won't get in trouble. Don't worry. I was the better man. Yeah, I'll miss you too. I love you, Mum. I'll see you again soon. I'm gonna go out to the Wild West today. Okay. Yeah, bye, Mum. You take care. I'll see you soon. Bye.
Considering this is my first horse and I got it yesterday, I'm going to go with I'll be alright. Could you just say that to both of them? I told you I just got my horse yesterday. Yeah? Are you saying that to both as well? I don't know, it's like I'm...
Hello. Sorry, did you say something to me?
Oh, I was just saying howdy.
Oh, hello.
How you doing?
I'm doing all right, thanks. How are you?
I'm doing all right.
My name's Rodney Spencer.
Pleasure meeting you. I'm Deputy Eleanor Parker. You have a really wonderful outfit, I would say, Don.
Oh, thank you very much. It's very kind of you. Yeah, my mother got it for me when I was 14, when the fair came to Colchester. And there was a man who had a hamburger and hot dog stall, and his name was Woody, and his stall was called Woody's Ground Up. So my mother had a nice little chat with him for about 10 minutes, and went off to clean his caravan. And then when she came back, she said, "Woody's all tied up. It's time to go." And she was carrying these clothes. They were a bit, you know, too long for me when I was 14, but I've grown into them now.
Okay, got it. How long have you been in crossing?
About a month now.
Oh, really? I think I saw you around, but I haven't actually, like, talked to you.
Well, there's a lot of people mistake me for Huxley. I think we've ever, you know, very similar clothes.
For Huxley?
Yeah, Deputy Huxley.
No, I wouldn't. To be honest, I know Huxley. I wouldn't say.
There's a very rude man. He was just down there.
What?
And he was saying that my mother was a whore. And I just
don't
thought...
listen to them, all right?
No, I was quite cross with him, but I did contain myself.
Yeah, please. That's really good.
I don't want to get in trouble with the law.
That's really wonderful.
I had a fight in Rhodes just the other day because a ruffian just started on me for no reason at all. Just grabbed me round by the throat.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
That was the first fight I've ever had.
Okay, I see. Well, you didn't get hurt much?
No, he grabbed me round the throat, so I elbowed him in the stomach, and then I gave him a knuckle sandwich, and he fell to the ground. And then,
right, was it one of the locals? Or
was it was a local. It was outside Flood Store on the porch.
No, I mean, they attack you. It was a self-defense, so it's understandable.
Yeah, I was just having a nice chat with a nice young lady there called Myrtle, and was just having a nice talk, and then he just started on her, and he chased her up the street, and then when she came back, and then when she came back, he started on me, but, you know, he picked on the wrong man.
All right.
I'm trying to become a manly man. That's why I come to the Wild West.
Who you want to become? A manly man?
A manly man, yeah. Because I've got a problem.
You want to go to the West?
Well, I've been to the Wild West, you know.
Oh.
Actually, you know, out west over that way. But actually, you know, coming to sort of live here, I'll become a manly man because I've got a bit of an affliction, you see. I've got a lazy bladder. And the doctor said that I've got to become a manly man or I'd have to have an operation on my toilet area, and I don't want an operation on my toilet area.
Yeah. Hopefully you won't be having a surgery.
Yeah, it's a bit embarrassing, really. So.
No, yeah. It's alright. Everyone has their own problems. It's not something you should be embarrassed about.
Well, I've had it all my life. My mother took me out of school and homeschooled me because the bigger boys called me Sprinkle Spencer.
Oh.
So she went down to the market and bought a big box of books. But unfortunately, they were water damaged, so I didn't get a very good education.
I see.
But I thought if I come to the Wild West, then I could become a manly man, you see?
Okay, yeah. I'm just going to... like say that it's the West is quite dangerous.
Yeah, everyone's been really nice, apart from that man down there. He was very rude, calling my mother a whore. My mother works in the saloon, you see. She works up in the bedrooms, because she's a cleaner.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely a cleaner, and men do go in the room, and they help her move the bed, so she can get behind it and dust it. Yeah. Anyway, I'm sure you've got a lot of things to do. It's very nice meeting you.
Very nice meeting you too. Just be careful and...
I will do.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I did some work here, actually.
Really?
Yeah, you know the shiplap boarding? There were some loose ones all the way round, so I fixed them back about 3 days ago. They seem to be all right, don't they? Yeah. Because I'm a sort of handyman, you know, I could do carpentry and odd jobs.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
That's really wonderful.
And that's manly, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Anyway, I better go. I'm going to go back out to the Wild West and see what's going on down there.
All right.
All right, you take care. Be safe.
Mm-hmm. You too.
Bye. Quick look in Blackwater, I think.
Kind of. I nearly shot him.
Horse.
You are really nicely dressed up, look.
Thank you very much. Someone's taken my horse. I thought that was my horse over there, and it's not.
Oh,
It was a bit. Well, I tied it up to that tree there, and I thought that was Hazel because it was a bit dark. And
right.
And then when I went to find something in my saddlebag, I couldn't open it.
Huh. Okay, I see. So, I think maybe someone brought it back to the stables since your horse might not have been hitched. Someone spook it out, and just the rope was not pretty tight enough. Yeah. I was just going to the stables.
Okay, I'll go and have a look there. Thank you very much.
Yeah, of course, of course.
Now there you are, you wandered off. I found him, he was put back in the stable. Sorry, you're busy. I was just saying I found him. Look, he'd been put back in the stable.
Okay. Sorry, something happened with Mr. Red. I'm really happy you got your horse. You have a wonderful horse.
Thank you very much. He was only $40, and he's only ever thrown me off once because of the wolves. He's very loyal. I feed him and stroke him all the time. Sorry, you're busy, aren't you, with paperwork?
No, don't worry. I'm just finishing up something before going to bed. But I'm not minding having a talk. Don't worry about that. I'm actually really happy when people approach me because I was first scared when I was not even a deputy to approach them because I thought, oh, I'm distracting them. What am I doing? But I'm actually happy that people talk with me.
Well, it's nice to have a chat, isn't it, with nice people? I mean, you know, everybody's been really nice to me since I've been here. You know,
I'm really happy about
that. Yeah, which is nice, you know. But people do say I've got to be careful because there are some bad people. And obviously, mm-hmm. I met that man down there who was very rude. You know, I think if you're nice to people, they're normally nice back, aren't they?
Well, usually, but sometimes people can answer you back on something else. But what you need to remember is those words are not going to hurt you, okay?
Yeah.
They might hurt you mentally, but you need to ignore them, okay?
And yeah.
Of course, not initiate any fight or continue that. Just walking away, you know what? Because you have people who care about you. I think you're a good person.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you just got to, you know, have a stiff upper lip and not let them get the better of you and let
mm-hmm.
them show that,
That's
you know,
right.
they've hurt your feelings.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, anyway. You have a nice evening and I hope you sleep
Thank
well.
You.
It's nice chatting
Thank
you
so
to
much.
You. Bye-bye.
You too.
Bye. Bye.
Gonna make it that much better. only talk about it. It only makes it worse to live.
Can hear wolves. Can hear it. I think I scared it off.
was looking at all the life. There were plants and birds and rocks and things. There was sand and hills and rain. The first thing I met was a fly with a buzz and the sky with no clouds. The heat was hot.
Oh,
One is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. Two can be as bad as one. It's the loneliest number since the number one. No is the saddest experience you'll ever know. Yes, it's the saddest experience you'll ever know. Because one is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. One is the loneliest number that you'll ever know. It's just no good anymore since you went away. Now I spend my time just making rhymes of yesterday. Because one is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. One is the loneliest number that you'll ever know. One is the loneliest number. One is the loneliest number. One is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. One is the loneliest number, much, much worse than two. A number divided by two. Hello there. Hello. Hello there. Hello. I'm looking for Peter Rockwell.
I've not seen him around just now. I don't often see him around at this time.
Oh, just...
So I can't see where he's usually around, to be honest.
Oh, okay. It's just that someone told me that he's selling treasure maps, and I was just trying to find him.
You know what? I don't even know a telegram number. He might have it in the... I know he does a piece in the newspaper.
Okay.
Where he has clues to do with treasure, and that might have a... That may have a telegram number on it that you can get in contact with.
Oh, I have got his telegram number. I was just passing through this way, and I just thought I might, you know, bump into him. I just wondered if you'd seen him about.
Ah, right, yeah, of course. Well, unfortunately, I haven't seen him just now.
That's okay, no problem. Thanks for your help anyway.
Aye, you take care. All the best.
And you too. Take care now. There goes the law. Wonder who they're after. Hello there. Hello there. I don't suppose you've seen Flood at all tonight, have you?
No, we've only just got into town, unfortunately, so I'm not too sure.
Oh, is that McAllister?
Aye, yes, how are you doing?
Hello, I'm not too bad, how are you?
Yeah, not too bad, thank you.
Well, that's good. Well, have a nice evening and stay safe.
I do my best, you too.
Bye.
Mother Nature's son, all day long I'm sitting singing songs for everyone. Sit beside a mountain stream, see her waters rise, listen to the pretty sound of music as she flies. Swaying daisies sing a lazy song.